Welcome to Fun on the Run. I am Yolanda Williams. We're at the Dallas Holocaust and Human Rights Museum in downtown Dallas, and we're about to get an education in human and civil rights in America.
Thank you for having us today, Mary Pat.
Thanks so much for being here, Yolanda.
Thank you so much. So tell me, why do you think you guys are being recognized as one of the top museums in Dallas?
Well, we're very excited about this recognition because we've worked really hard to build a museum that features the history of the Holocaust, teaches us about the human rights framework, and then really looks at the importance of being an upstander in the United States today. Yes. And I think we resonate with people because we have so much history. Yes. Anyone can come to our museum and find history that's relevant to them. When you're studying history, and the history of the Holocaust in particular, there were 6 million Jews who were murdered.
Wow.
That's 6 million stories. And so I'm just constantly amazed that there's a new story, new history that I didn't know.
Right.
And I learn a lot from visitors who come to the museum.
I'm sure you do. There's so many people here today.
So this is a map of occupied Europe during World War II. And the pins on the map represent 6% of the camp system, of the Nazi camp system.
Okay.
So many of us know Dachau.
Sure.
Or Buchenwald or Auschwitz-Birkenau. But the U.S. Holocaust and Memorial Museum has been studying this and has found that there were 44,000 camps.
Wow.
44,000. These pins represent 6%.
6%?
Yes. And so the takeaway is it was across Europe, and it would have been impossible to live there and
yes.
not know that people were being starved to death, tortured, you know, that the brutality was in your face. Now we're in the Human Rights Gallery.
Yes.
And we learn about the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, that Eleanor Roosevelt co-chaired this committee for
yes.
the United Nations, and every UN member nation ratified this aspirational document to say
sure.
that these 29 rights all humans should enjoy.
So
Yolanda, we're going to enter a gallery about genocide.
Oh, wow.
And we teach about the process of genocide, the 10 stages of genocide in this gallery. So you can see it's a totally different exhibition style.
Wow.
Each one of the stages is exemplified by a historic genocide.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, for example, we start with classification. Genocide starts by classifying people, breaking people into groups.
Yes.
And so we use the Guatemalan genocide to define that.
So Mary Pat, where are we now?
Well, we're entering the gallery called Pivot to America.
Mm.
And in this gallery, we explore the evolution of different rights for Americans.
Mm-hmm.
We celebrate upstanders who brought about change. And this installation, there's an amazing Dallas upstander, Clarence Broadnax, this gentleman with the glasses.
Yes.
He was the first African-American hairdresser at the downtown Neiman's,
mm-hmm.
and he went over for lunch at the Piccadilly cafeteria and was denied service.
Wow.
So he and Juanita Craft organized protests for 30 days, and at the end of that time period, the Piccadilly
changed
their policy.
Uh-huh.
Yes, ma'am. So you just sit and you pick up this little ear can,
uh-huh.
and then like I'll hit Ku Klux Klan.
Okay.
And everybody was wearing white gowns with pointed hats. And I thought to myself, is that the Klan?
And then you can...
So somebody's actually doing an audible type of
uh-huh.
history that you can sit here
that
and listen to.
That you can just sit and absorb.
Wow, you got Selma March, Little Rock Integration, Freedom Rides.
Yeah.
Wow.
We were talking about John Lewis, Selma March.
Yeah, uh-huh, I know.
That famous, there he was leading the way. You can choose
oh.
among 12 different categories
okay.
of history that really is of interest to you.
Mm-hmm.
So African-American experience.
Let's see, so you just touch that?
You touch that.
Oh, wow, look at this.
And then it's a timeline, so you
I
could either
this.
Go, you know, event
Let's
by
do.
Event or just pick a day. Yeah, so what was in 1961?
Mr. Broadnax.
There we go.
Who we were just talking about.
There we go.
Wow.
Well, Mary Pat, you have to tell everybody, if they want to come and get a nice little education
yes, ma'am.
On civil rights and human rights, how can they find you guys online and on social media?
Well, our full name is Dallas Holocaust and Human Rights
mm-hmm.
Museum. The initials are DHHRM, so you can Google us. You can go to our Facebook page. You can go to our website online and buy tickets. We're open 6 days a week, so we're only closed on Tuesdays.
Okay, gotcha.
And, you know, we're open from 10 to 5, so I hope people will come and check us out.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. Hey, you guys, if you want to see more stories like these, please visit us at CW33.com and make sure to follow us on social media.